Thank you, Madam Chair, for giving me the opportunity to speak on this very important legislation. On the onset, I will like to congratulate our Honorable Minister and our Honorable Prime Minister for getting in the much-needed legal framework in this particular industry. As we all know, ma'am, India is leading in the field of ship recycling industry with a share of 30% of global ship recycling industry. This bill will only strengthen our stand in that direction. This bill will further boost our economy and also guarantee more employment for a large number of people, both in direct and indirect ways. Ma'am, today we are living in a very competitive world. Therefore, our domestic rules and regulations have to align with the global standards and conventions. If we lag behind, we will never be able to compete or meet up to the global market standards. When our objective is to make India a 5 trillion economy, it becomes imperative that every sector functions as its optimum. Therefore, we cannot afford to stand behind in any sector, including this. Ma'am, our visionary Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Bhai Modi, is recognizing challenges in this industry and also our commitment as a member of International Maritime Organization, which is IMO, and hence has brought this bill to make this sector more competent and competitive, thereby adhering to the global norms. So currently, the regulatory framework which we have in our country in the form of Ship Breaking Code 2013 is in place in India, which has exclusive provisions containing general instructions for safety, health, environment compliance for stakeholders involved in ship recycling. It has taken care of a lot of things. However, there are some shortcomings in that Ship Breaking Code of 2013. The said code does not provide penalties and contraventions for provisions on or deal with restrictions and prohibitions on the use of hazardous material on the ships. My colleague and also MP from Bhavnagar just mentioned about accidents being caused due to such kind of substance or installments used on the ships, which can cause accidents sometimes. And to avoid that, I think this bill is very important. Our Honorable Minister also comes from the same area where Alang ship breaking yard is, and even he is aware of the shortcomings of this particular code that we had available, and to give it more stronger legal framework, I think this bill is very, very important. So therefore, it makes it difficult for the enforcement agency in dealing with the violations of the code. I strongly feel that this bill is a corrective step in this direction. I would briefly put forth the international provisions in this regard. Ma'am, in global context, International Maritime Organization, a specialized agency of United Nations, is involved in ensuring the safety and security of international shipping, marine and atmospheric pollution. It has adopted the Hong Kong International Convention for the Safe and Environmentally Sound Recycling of the Ships, 2009. It ensures that these ships, when being recycled after the end of their operational lives, do not pose any unnecessary risk to the environment, human health or safety. India, being a member of IMO, has participated in the convention and also expressed views on human safety and India's environmental concerns. Not only the global environmental concerns, but India per se. Whatever concerns we had, our country is strongly voiced for it. The proposed bill provides the legal framework for implementing the provisions of the Hong Kong Convention. Sir, Ma'am, as we all know, until the 20th century, my colleagues here voiced the concern that India shouldn't become a dumping yard. But we all know that recycling used to take place all over the world, including USA, UK, where after that it moved to North America, South Asia. Today there are five major countries who are global players in this industry, namely India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, China and Turkey. As per United Nations Conference on Trade and Development report on review of maritime transportation, ma'am, I'm trying to by this given example here that how important this industry is to India and how globally we stand as a leader today globally in this particular industry. India demolished around 6,300 tons in 2017 of known ship scraping across the world. In 2018, only 744 ships were recycled all over the world. But in India, 240 ships were recycled in only 2018 and 19. The government plans to further increase its share in the world market by 2024. So as we all know, India is today a leader in this particular segment globally, and the volume as far as the dumping concerns, again the volume of valuable materials that get recovered, repaired, reused, refurbished and recycled makes the ship recycling an essential element in the global transition to a circular economy. Ma'am, we are a hub in this industry and we are committed to increase our share in the global industry and to consolidate our position as a global leader. This will also create employment in our country. Ma'am, I also belong to the state of Gujarat, which again I repeat leads the ship recycling industry, with Alang being the world's most and one of the largest shipbreaking towns. Shipbreaking industry does exist in my constituency too, but on a much smaller scale. Almost a third of all retired vessels, at least about 200 each year, are sent to be broken up here from all over the world and to about 100 different yards stretching in about 10 kilometers land. This industry provides employment to a large number of people and also to the ones who migrate from the other states. This industry also contributes significantly to the state's economy. Our state government also has taken several steps to develop Alang as an eco-friendly yard. After it has been a sustained effort by a state government to ensure that it is an eco-friendly yard which generates both environmentally friendly work as well as employment, gives a healthy atmosphere to all the laborers to work. The yard will be only such place in the world which even has provisions or facilities to dismantle warships. There is another reason for why this proposed legislation is important and also essential. It is true that we are a market leader in ship dismantling and ship recycling. But of late, Madam Chair, we've been facing a lot of challenges, and one of the major challenges is the movement of freight prices. The current earnings and future expectation drive the ship recycling industry. The movement in freight prices is indicated by Baltic Drive Index, as we all know. Now the BDI is shipping and trade index created by London-based Baltic Index. The other index includes Baltic Dirty Tanker Index and Baltic Clean Tanker Index, which is linked to freight prices of oil tankers. These indexes specify the cost of the transportation to the ship owners. The cyclicality in the ship breaking industry is inherent with its negative correlation with the Baltic indexes. Better availability of ships is expected in the time of recessions when the freight rates are lower, as ship owners find it economically viable to send the ship for the purpose of recycling rather than using the ship further. Our industry is impacted by the availability of the ships with the rise of Baltic indexes as of now. However, the present situation is that the ship breaking or recycling industry is growing very fast due to global downturn and ship business and economic slump. We all know there's a global slowdown, and because of that, this particular industry is growing very, very fast. So to capitalize on this growth, also we need this bill. We need to take this opportunity to grow our footprints in the industry, which is not possible until we have a law and rules of enforcement. Therefore, we immediately need this law in the interest of this particular industry's growth. Other challenges visible are, ma'am, I'll conclude in 5 minutes. Our scrap prices vis-a-vis steel price, movement profitability of ship breakers susceptible to steel scrap prices, which are linked to global steel prices, while poor ship purchase, ship recycler or breaker have to bear the price risk. Competition from global peers is another very, very serious challenge that our industry is facing. Indian industry faces intense competition from neighboring countries like Pakistan, Bangladesh, and since Pakistan has availability to low wage, lack of occupational and health and environmental related regulations, it is very easy for them to sort of work and grow. And they have very partial enforcement also. We are being also closely challenged by Bangladesh, as they have also already enacted a legislation for ship recycling, just in case Bangladesh was to accede to the Hong Kong Convention before us and become the first country in South Asia to do so, it will certainly damage our business interest. So since we have competition from them, we have to think about our Asian markets as well in this direction. And that's why I think it's not a good idea to lose a significant market, and it's better to have this bill in form of law so that we can capture the global market even more strongly. With this bill becoming an act, we'll be able to protect our business interests and also position ourselves strongly world over again in this industry. The other very important aspect is the protection of environment. A lot of concerns were voiced here regarding the environment. Ship breaking is a green process. There were members who were also saying whether this is ship recycling bill or a ship breaking bill. No, this is a ship recycling bill because it is a totally green process. Everything that is broken and found is recycled with very little impact both to the environment or human life. Wherein the ship at the end of its life cycle, as each part is sent for further reuse. So it is a green process. At the same time, ma'am, just concluding, but I have to add something from my constituency also, ma'am. Give me 2 more minutes. Concluding. At the same time, it is true that the complex process of dismantling involves issues like labor safety, health, and it poses serious challenges to the environment. So if left unregulated, we all know that this is a hazardous process. It has a lot of challenges. So if it is better to regulate it, then leave it unregulated. So this bill will regulate this entire sector in a great, great way. And if we just leave it unattended, I think that is when we will cause a major... Ma'am, just 2 more minutes. Just 2 more minutes. Let me conclude. I don't think many members are speaking. I was told. Let me conclude. 2 more minutes. The bill... See, even Dada is agreeing, so let me speak. 2 more minutes. Ma'am, please. Thank you, Dada. That's okay. As long as he supports us, we're fine. The bill has provision in Clause 21 to address these environmental concerns. The clause also ensures safety to every ship recycler. This bill includes environment regulations for the management of hazardous material and also penalties and punishment for the contraventions of the environmental guidelines in Clause 22, making it much effective than the previous Shipbreaking Code to 2013. As we already know that this is a job-providing sector, the importance to recognize importance of laborers and migrant laborers is also taken care of. The laborers' interest is protected under Clause 15.1, Clause 15.2 of this particular bill. Both from the safety and environmental angle, this bill has provisions which restricts and prohibits the use or installation of hazardous material, which applies irrespective whether a ship is meant for recycling or not. This bill takes care of all our safety concerns as far as the ships are concerned, because installation... Sir, just 2 minutes. Concluding, sir. I'm coming to the last...
Please
last
conclude now. You have taken last more time, than sir. 17 minutes.
This, recycling or not, this restriction will immediately, from the date of the legislation coming into force, while existing ships shall have the period of 5 years for the compliance of the same. Sir, I'm trying to explain what the bill is. Let me at least highlight the important points. I'm almost done. Sir, I want to take my constituency's
issue. Yes, very small bill. You have to take already 17 minutes.
All the ships which are surveyed and certified on inventory of hazardous material, as per the provisions of the bill, only shall be recycled. No other ships will be recycled unless they have been surveyed in this regard. Sir, my submission at the end is that though the size of shipbreaking industry is relatively small, but it is strong linkage with independent variables, environment regulations, freight prices and steel scrap prices, sets itself apart from the industry. Sir, last sentence.
Please.
Sir, with last sentence, I will like to congratulate the Honorable Minister.
Soundji, 8 minutes.
1 minute. Honorable Minister, for this particular bill, I wholeheartedly support the bill, and one request I have to make to the Honorable Minister. Sir, we have a very small shipbreaking yard in Sachana, Jamnagar, which as you know is has a legal litigation issues with the Maritime Board
and
the Forest Authority. Sir, I would request for your kind intervention in that regard. And again, make our shipbreaking and ship recycling yard functional. Thank you very much, Speaker, sir. Thank you so much.